Hit that button. So we're good. What's up? So
my fault. What's up, y'all? This is what's up, y'all? This is Hobie Jolly Dangerous. I'm here with the other part of Neo Digital Podcast.
My name is Denonu YouTube. What's going on?
Yeah, and Denonu was like, yo. No, I think I was talking about American Gods. He was like, yo, I heard about that. I had never seen it before. I was like,
nope.
Well, good sir. let me learn you something. And so he's gonna be reacting to Anansi's story of black people on a boat, the American Gods TV show.
Okay, and, so they're talking about how black people was brought into slavery.
Just watch it. Okay.
All right, let me just make sure. Anansi, he's the African, if my static shock is correct, he's the African spider god?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so he's not a god of spiders. He is actually a god who was a spider.
Okay.
In African folklore. And they pray to him for certain things. I forgot what he was. Essentially, he is like Loki.
Okay.
So he's like an African trickster god.
Okay.
All right. So also, yeah, thank you. You hit the giant ass fucking mouse cursor. I don't know why the cursor's that big. All right.
All right, let me hit this play button. See what we're getting into. Coming to America. Signed, Eddie Murphy. In 1692-7. That's right.
Your history sucks.
Got a smooth saxophone playing.
I'm telling you, I love this scene.
Anansi, compare Anansi. Biko in a no num, a wedding film in Yemchibia. Mana in my fairing ne. Oh, yes, you could yip a lampe. Mana in my head to us, yari put a nansubo. And do you, Bobutello, a keg of marble? A wedding meeky. Igbe ego maobu iko aka maobu ihota nkuru osisi bia chiegi n'iru mana ị na-anụ ọnụ biko nyere ụmụ ebele biko nyere ụmụaka ka nsi ebe a pụta aga m agụrụ gị ego ndụ niile. Aga m ewetara gị ife onyinye, akpụkpọ anụ, na ofe, na akwa silk, na mmanya dele ede.
I feel like he gonna tell him something like, I don't need your, you know, your crappy things or something. Like, he gonna talk down to him or something. I feel like he gonna get super ignorant.
She wouldn't give it up for Hannes up there, so he threw her off the boat.
Oh, damn.
Did you know your mama couldn't swim? You all need to work on that. Take swimming lessons. This is how we get stereotypes.
Anansi.
You won't help? Fine. Let me tell you a story. Once upon a time, a man got fucked. Now, how is that for a story? Because that's the story of black people in America.
I'm wrong about that.
Shit. You all don't know you black yet. You think you just people. Let me be the first to tell you that you are all black. The moment these Dutch motherfuckers set foot here and decided they white, and you get to be black, and that's the nice name they call you? Let me paint a picture of what's waiting for you on the shore. You arrive in America, land of opportunity, milk and honey, and guess what? You all get to be slaves. Split up, sold off, and worked to death. The lucky ones get Sunday off to sleep and buck and make more slaves and all for what? For cotton, indigo, for a fucking purple shirt.
The only good news is he didn't have to pop the shirt. Farm for
free. He's gonna give a shitload of these white motherfuckers cancer.
Oh, my bad. Can you go back?
And I haven't even started yet. 100 decided they white, and you get to be black, and that's the nice name they call you? Let me paint a picture of what's waiting for you on the shore. You arrive in America, land of opportunity, milk and honey, and guess what?
Liking the way this is going so far, though. We still got, what, like 3 more minutes of this?
And work to death.
It's better.
The lucky ones get Sunday off to sleep and buck and make most slaves and all for what? For cotton, indigo, for a fucking purple shirt. The only good news is the tobacco your grandkids are gonna farm for free is gonna give a shitload of these white motherfuckers cancer. And I ain't even started yet. 100 years later, you're fucked. 100 years after that, fucked. 100 years after you get free, you still getting fucked out of job and shot at by police. You see what I'm saying? This guy gets it. I like him. He's getting angry. Angry is good. Angry gets shit done. You shed tears for Kumbi Anansi, and here he is telling you, you are staring down the barrel of 300 years of subjugation, racist bullshit, and heart disease. He is telling you there is one goddamn reason you shouldn't go up there right now and slit the throats of every last one of these Dutch motherfuckers and set fire to this ship.
Mana, gomile gaboku.
You already dead, asshole. At least die a sacrifice for something worthwhile. Let the mother.
Not wrong about that.
Burn. Not at all.
Is he gonna grab the lantern and burn the ship?
The whole time, like the saxophone is just like,
yeah,
background.
That's cool. Yeah, I agree with that. Taking that Killmonger approach, I like it.
Check this shit out.
Oh, you mean it's not over?
No.
Oh, is he floating in the ocean? Oh, so he made it, but they didn't. I don't know much about the show, but I'm assuming that can he, I mean, since he already knows about everything, that they're, I forget what they call it in Marvel, where they know everything. Okay. But I'm assuming they know everything, like, throughout history, because he's knowing all this, he's not stuck in the present like everybody else.
Yeah.
So did that ship take him to America, or did he, or can they just be anywhere they want? I'm assuming
that's anywhere they're basically anywhere black people are.
Okay.
So the same guy there is the same guy in the future, same guy in the past.
Mm.
It's one of those see all know all type things.
Yeah.
So it doesn't really say, even in the book, it didn't really say that they can travel through time and like affect things.
Mm.
But with him, it's like he knows everything that happens to black people because he's like the black god.
Okay.
And
maybe it's like a Dr. Manhattan kind of sort of thing where throughout the span of his life, he experiences everything.
Yeah.
So
yeah, there you go. I want to say it's like that because these are the same guys that were like, they still go through time like everybody else, but he just knows what's going to happen to him because he's experienced it and he sees it.
That has me interested in this show. I'm gonna watch this tomorrow.
Yo, so it turns out I read up on his character, on Orlando Jones' character in here.
Mm-hmm.
He helped write that. He wrote that speech.
Yeah, that is a modern speech. A lot of the words and stuff he would use, and they would not even get. So but that's cool that they're willing to at least say that in a TV show and not cut that from the script. That's cool.
Yeah, like so that's something they talk about too. Is like they asked him if he can write something for it, and it's like, are you sure?
Yeah, do you really want me to write something, or do you want me to just bullshit?
So they wrote it and they kept it, and they didn't ask him to change anything because it was one of those like, we're really gonna say this on cable. And it's
social commentary. It's like what you were saying, telling me before about the money god and stuff. It's like there, if the whole show was basically about social commentary about all the different gods and religions and the stereotypes and our worship of a lot of that stuff, then I'm gonna probably love that a lot of this show.
Yeah, this shit got so deep. Like when this dropped, everyone was like, the comments on Twitter, Instagram, like it was one of those, you for it or you against it, or you're just like, it triggered people. And
that's what you want. I mean, you want to trigger people because that gets, it's like you put out a YouTube video. You want that divisive commentary. It can be a benefit for you because it draws people into your stuff, draws people to watch their show, to get people to write articles about it. So they'd be like, oh, I wonder what this American Gods thing is about. Gets people watching. But it's also a negative too, because it can bring controversy. They may not want the negative publicity if it's something that's like super bad. And in YouTube's case, it can bring a lot of negativity that can overwhelm the positivity of it. So
his character is like that throughout the whole.
Okay.
I wouldn't say he's black militant, but he's definitely wild. Like you can tell what side he's on.
Yeah.
And what he speaks about. And it's just like, geez. It's his character I love his character because I love how just he gets intense. He's like, he gets lost, dog. And it's just like, I'm looking at this dude, he's like, he's really him. So he's all through the second season currently, but from the news that I saw, and this happened a while ago, he's no longer with the show. So I got to look back at. I went through this rabbit hole of like, why is he no longer on the show, and what happened, and like the interviews, and like it's not set in stone exactly what happened. He's talked about it, but it's still kind of elusive. I just need to go back and watch it, since now I know more people who worked on the show. I can see and put faces to the names and such.
Yeah, it sounds like maybe he's trying to be politically correct about it. Usually when Hollywood and stuff have those breakups with actors on shows, it's like, you can come out there and say everybody's dirty laundry. But then you may not get work no more with that company or whatever. So it's like, oh, if he ain't talking about it, if they haven't released any kind of public press statement about it, then it's like, okay, well, they're trying not to say exactly what happened. But
back then, his Twitter beef, he had Twitter beef with other black actors. I was like, oh my God, what is going on here? I was trying to follow everybody. He had Twitter beef with, I think, with the main dude on the show. But he didn't, like, the main dude didn't even say that much. And it was another guy on another show called 100 or something like that. It's like a show that's, I think,
sci-fi show, right?
Yeah. It was a black dude on there. And that the black dude on there, it turns out he's like super conservative. I was like, you hate black people as much as Trump does.
Okay.
Like, I remember that that dude was talking shit to him, like, and then vice versa. It was just like, if Orlando Jones is like on a lefty,
this he was his antithesis.
Yeah, I was like, what is going on here?
He was a super villain on the right.
It's like a high school beef. I was just like, okay. yeah, how'd you like this? Did you like this?
Yeah, I loved it. This is right on my alley.
Yeah.
I can agree with a lot of that. My dad was that same way of thinking. So it's, I grew up with a lot of stuff like this. So yeah, I'd love the hell out of it so far.
Cool.
I'm hoping the rest of the show is this deep when it comes to its messages. Then I'll probably, love all the other ones too.
It is. Okay. Yeah. There's not that many wasted scenes or wasted words in this show. And I say, I do not say that lightly. There's not that many wasted words. It's not filler. Nothing in the show.
Is there like, a lot of TV shows do the typical BS. Is there like manufactured drama and stuff? Because usually when you have bad writing, you have a lot of stereotypical things and stuff like that. Or
there is like a love triangle that goes on. I would say it was unnecessary because that love triangle didn't happen in the book. Mm. So it was definitely something that was made for TV. Other than that, it's like it didn't really get in the way because the overarching idea from the book is still in the show, even with the love triangle.
Okay.
So it just kind of like, I guess, intensified it even more because without that, I think that in the TV show, you really wouldn't care either way what happened to these characters if you didn't have that. And you'll know exactly what I'm talking about when you watch it. And then also when you go back and listen to the audiobook, it's almost like night and day. Like in the audiobook, it's more the focus on the battlefield and what's like the war component. This is more focused on the adventure to gaining people in order to go do the war. It's just like a keep constant build up, a crescendo almost to what it's supposed to
be. Okay. All right, I see what you're saying. And you have probably love interests or main characters in there to make you care about the characters, to make you care about what happens in the show, to keep you watching it. I guess it's probably just like
just one, and it's very relevant because it's basically Shadow Moon's wife, and you'll see all that stuff. Like it's great.
All right, yeah, I'm gonna check this out tomorrow, and maybe we can do a follow up video once I watch the whole thing, and we can definitely talk about it.
Okay, so this is episode two. You gotta watch one and two.
Well, I was going to try to binge watch the whole thing. Oh, so, yeah. So my dad's...
Each one is an hour, so...
I've done it before. But I'll definitely watch this and the first one tomorrow, though.
Okay. If you guys want to see any more of these videos, these reaction-type videos, let us know in the comments below. You can also follow us on Twitter. I don't really talk that much on Twitter, but I always check it. Just in case. So links in the description. We'll catch you guys on the next one.
Later, fellas.